So today, first of all, thank you for having me here. Today, I'm going to talk about everyone's inventor. So first, let's take a look at this short video to give you an idea how Microduino can tell an interesting story. By the way, all the products showing you here are powered by Microduino modules.
Based on that, we are developing series products for different age groups.
and we are using our educational theory, our methodology, together we are serving all the markets in terms of STEM STEAM education. So this is a map of our worldwide customer base. As you can see, all the dots are the real data from our system. We already covered all six continents, and hopefully sometime soon, the UCSD Oceanographic Group, they will bring Microduino to Antarctica, so we can change the number to 7. And we have over 100 different module sensors, and we are serving over 5,000 schools and over 3 million students. So we have a big community. And the awards, with our patent technology, we have received so many awards around the world. For instance, the Time magazine named us the top 5 things to teach kids about computer coding, and the IDSA give us the gold award for IDSA, which considering the Oscar of Design Award. And the Maker Faire, we were named the 5 best things from the World Maker Faire in 2016, and we received the Editor's Choice for 17 and 18. And this year we got 4 NAPA awards for 4 of our products as well. And we are working with many schools, industrial leaders and organizations. So compared with the traditional lecture, which is more linear, targeted, and teach basic skills, our flipped classroom is more non-linear, free format, cultivates the personal exploration, individual creativity, and creative class. It's like a human brain. The left brain is really logic, science, math, and the right brain is art, creativity, imagination. When you combine those two together, it can be really powerful. So we effectively model the balance between the instructor-led versus the self-driven learning. Combine our technology products, our program tools, methodology, and the curriculum into a complete package for K-12 and higher education. This is a picture showing we are in education everywhere. And it's happening every day. For instance, so we actually we even have a 2-unit course at Tsinghua University, which is the best university in China. And we are supporting many STEM events. For instance, 4 years in a row, we were the judge for the first robotic competition. Now, let me give you one example to show you how we can help turn your idea into reality. For instance, you see this is our Microduino modules. In the class, we will really ask the question, what key component you need to build a, say, LED light. Trust me, all the students can easily come up with the list. You will need the LED, of course, and you will need a sort of a controller or switch, and you will need a power. So you just simply snap those three together, then here you go, you have the LED lights. Now, if you want to add some more functions to it, if I add the OLED display, you see you have the OLED display. And if you add the motion module, the motion sensor will detect the movement and change the color of the light. And if you add the display again, it becomes an electronic level. Perfect level will be smiling face and the green light. Not perfect, it will tilt with sad face and different color. So this is just a quick demo to show you how easily you can add more function to your build, add more function to your products. Of course, if you add a Wi-Fi, then it's online, it's an IoT device. Even your friends from Beijing, from Tokyo can control this. If you add Bluetooth, then the cell phone can control this. So it's really how you want to control your own project, own device. Now, another example, what key component do you need to build a music box? Anyone? Yes, yeah, speaker for sure. Anything else? For music box?
Storage.
Yes, storage.
Static.
Yes. You see, I won't waste time, but you see it's very easy that you can come up with the list. And what we will do is we will give you the corresponding modules. And you just need to snap them together and connect with the speaker, then boom, you have the working prototype. Before, from the idea of making a using bugs to really make a prototype, it takes really long process. But now we are shrinking the process and we are concentrating on the next step. We will always ask the students what interesting features or interactive features that we can design to make them more interesting. That very close to those commercialized products. So never underestimate students' creativity. They just need something to inspire. You see, those are all the music box from our class. But really, the students' design make it more interesting, make it more personal and unique. Here are more samples. I'm pretty sure the purse is from a girl. So anyway, let me give you a couple of case study to show you how we can help in the real life application. Let's talk about vultures. Why? They are important for people and the environment. They stop the killing disease. However, unfortunately, 99.9% of vultures being wiped out. So the International Center for Birds of Prey in UK, they want to do something to help. Here's how. They want to create an artificial egg looks exactly like the real one, and putting all the sensors inside to monitor the surface temperature, the humidity, rotation, light, and so on and so forth during the incubation. So initially, of course, they thought about the Arduino. But as you can see, the Arduino, the mother vulture wouldn't be happy to see the Arduino egg around the nest. So Microduino came to rescue. With all necessary modules snapped together, we still have lots of room for battery and other components. So our team was able to implement the whole system all the way from the app, which is the data collection, to the relay knob, to the cloud, while giving Mother Nature a helping hand in the process. So let's take a look at how discovery has
been. Okay, so yeah, let's go. This 3D printed egg could be the key to saving endangered vultures. It's chock full of tech, from a micro Arduino core to Bluetooth and multi-sensory modules to temperature and humidity sensors. This egg has it all. It'll be used to collect important data from inside nests. That information will be wirelessly relayed to a nearby terminal. Conservationists can then use the data to better understand breeding behavior and how they can help vulture populations in captivity. This unique method of data collection is a joint effort between the International Center for Birds of Prey and Microduino. Eggs are slated for field testing this month. Guess it's time to get cracking.
I guess they are pretty happy with this. So, here's another example to show you how we can help in a commercial application. This is the project we work with Nescafe.
Introducing the Nescafe Alarm Cap. In 2014, Nescafe decided to renew its image, and with that, its iconic packaging. Through scientifically proven light and sound sequences designed to stimulate people, we turned Nescafe's cap into an alarm clock. Opening the cap turns the alarm off, and what you need to work out with the unique aroma of Nescafe. The alarm caps are currently awakening Nescafe lovers, opinion leaders, and media personalities around the world. Caps are designed to reach every home and show us the best way to wake up is to awaken ourselves.
By show of hands, who snoozes their alarm multiple times in the morning? Finally, though, the only thing that wakes you up is the cup of coffee. So imagine 6 a.m. in the morning when the alarm goes off, you just twist open the cap and then turn off the alarm. Then smell the fresh aroma of coffee. So we present actually Nescafe alarm cap. But the reason I brought this up, this is a brilliant idea, but the reason I brought this up is to show you with Microduino you can also design or create something more elegantly, more efficiently as this. So our goal is with Microduino, everyone is an inventor. Microduino has come a long way, become something valuable today. With Microduino, everyone is an inventor. So how did I turn this big idea into what we have today. Let's take a trip down memory lane. Back in 1996, I just enrolled in material science at Fudan University, MAD equivalent to China. I received the first class education from great professors. I felt like I was ready to tackle the world. One really cold winter, I was walking back to my dorm, and one student stopped me asking for directions. He was an international student, so I was afraid that he could misunderstand my directions and risk death. So I invited him back to my dorm and drew him a map. Well, he told me he didn't have enough money to be enrolled in the next semester's class. So I thought that was terrible. So I lent him as much money as I could spare. After he left, I realized it was really cold outside. So I went out and lent him my jacket too. As you probably already guessed, that I never saw that guy ever again. So I left my jacket and I still think about it. I was scammed and I felt betrayed, but I would do it all over again. The most important difference being that now I would know that getting scammed is a possibility, and I just got to know that poor guy better. So now I'm not telling you to give you bank information to some random African prince, just because he's dying to share his inheritance. What I'm saying is, while you are, it's important that you stay a true sport to your own beliefs, always remember, be thorough, be tactful. So back in my undergraduate day, Tiki, one of our co-founder and I, we were in the college in Canada. We looked for any and all opportunities to perform in front of audiences. We would travel really far, like the distance from LA to Vegas, just trying to play a few songs in a tiny little radio station. Was it worth it? Well, we had our desire, and we made it happen, so it was. Think big, start small. After I graduated from Fudan University, I went to UCSD for my master's in EE. A student in my program once told me to accomplish at least one thing every day. And he would not get a PhD at the Caltech, so that was probably a pretty good advice for me. So when I finally got my master's, I was at a crossroad. Do I work in a lab as an engineer with my technical background, or take a sales job in a tech company? I chose the latter. But wait, why would someone with a BS in material science and a master's in EE choose a sales job? Because I wanted to be an entrepreneur, and I needed a sales experience and people skill. In fact, actually being an engineer didn't actually conflict with working in sales. In fact, the best part is my technical background was absolutely priceless in my new role. So think big, start small. In the past, when device know, such as TVs and the ACs for controlled according to the manufacturer's specs. But we are giving people the freedom to give shape to their ideas. Maybe you want to control your visual lines according to voice chunk control, according to gestures, and even how drink you are after a party. We give you the choice. So once people get used to turning their ideas into reality instantly, this could even change people's lifestyles. We are also helping others in their careers become inventors. For instance, the students taking our class had great ideas, and then realized they were with Microduino, and then gone on to become entrepreneurs themselves. So again, with Microduino, everyone is an inventor. We think big, start small, and we hope you do the same thing. Think big, start small. Thank you very much. By the way, I was talking about the music box. This is one music box we built using our home modules. Basically, when you open the door, the light sensor detects the light, turn on the music. When you close it, it will turn on. So, and also we have the gesture control sensors here. So, when I do this, it will increase the volume. When I do this, it will decrease the volume. And when I do this, it will switch the next sound for me. So, it's really how you want to control your own project, your own device. I'm using the gesture control. And of course, you can use the microphone, then you can use the voice control or whatever. So that's how amazing you can, you know, use Microduino to turn your idea into reality. And also, recently we launched another new product we call a DDB buggy. So basically, it's a little buggy car, but when you add some Lego pieces, then you can make a 6 foot crawler, buggy, and whatever. And this guy, we are adding some motion sensors, modules, and the display to make a little robot here. And there will be our own multi-function controller with a display. And we have so many valves here. If I choose the first valve, if I do this, my motion will control the robot to go. And there are lots of sensors here that you can do the line tracing, you can even detect the color, so you can design your own block of color to play even music, like a very fast one. And this one is really silly, but we are trying to do a sort of gym series. You can push up, pull up, and everything. So, but anyway, the reason I'm trying to show this is to show you really with Microduino, whatever you can think of, you can just build it that way. Okay, any questions?
I have a 10-year-old grandson. This seems like the kind of thing you would enjoy. Do you have self-starter kits and then going to classes?
Yeah. Actually, we are doing lots of all kinds of events. Like we do a workshop, and we support the hackathon, like UCLA hackathon, UCSD hackathon, and last year we had our own hack festival. Basically, we invite lots of kids. So we are now doing a really serious hackathon, but we do a really fun day having kids to play with Microduino and to do whatever the products they want. And we also do lots of workshops in high school, middle school, college as well.
You have products, right, that if you a parent want the kid, they can just give it to their kid and they can follow the directions and just do it?
Yeah, sure.
Like Christmas gift wise.
Actually, I do have one.
Self-starter Christmas gift.
I do have one. I want to show you the videos. So I think we spent a lot of time to develop this one. And I think this is a perfect Christmas gift. It's fun to play, and it's easy to build. That's the fact. And you can build many different products within this one box. You can do the live fishing, and you can do the playing music. And also you can teach your kids scratch, drag and drop. You can even use your cell phone app to get a scratch code. Since we launched the recent 2 months, we are the number one new release on Amazon. So, but the beauty of the modular concept is, for instance, this buggy, actually we were adding the camera module on top, and then we trained the camera module to recognize certain patterns or certain color. So the rubber band machine gun you were seeing, that one can actually recognize even different color or different target to shoot only the targets. And also we use the camera to link with Microsoft Cloud, and then we can do some face recognition or face expression recognition thing. That's part of AI concept that we are teaching in schools. So it's really just adding more modules and people have more functions.
How is the board powered?
Always. Yeah. This one is our battery, and there's a DIR battery inside, and you can use the micro USB to charge it.
This might not be a
year. This one, actually you can consider this one as the mini version of Arduino board. Function-wise, it's the same, but we just make it smaller, and we make all the configuration the same, so we can snap. And we have a new version of battery. This one we call it the M-Center, actually. We incorporated the microcontroller inside. And also we added a Bluetooth inside. So this is a really very powerful already. And also this is a battery.
How long does it last when you charge it?
The power? It really depends on what products you are doing. I mean, if this is a small demo for my electronic level, this one could last maybe even 6 months for my demo purpose. But if you are doing something like a cars or some drones, then probably it's going to be drones probably is only 20 minutes. Yeah. So it really depends on what products, what application you are doing.
Does your company make all of the modules, or have any of the community contributing modules?
Most of the modules, actually, we do it. And we are really familiar with our design configuration already. But our community member always challenging us. Like, for instance, for the smartwatch project, actually, before, we only had the 5-volt controller, microcontroller. But this guy wants to do a 3.3-volt. For power consumption reason. So when we got lots of inquiry for 3.3 volts, we just go ahead and make it. And some customer, they need Wi-Fi Bluetooth, and some customer, they were asking like iBeacons. So we end up, we made iBeacons module. So that's why since beginning, we only have a few modules, and now we have over 50 different modules and 30 different sensors.
Is it possible to create your own modules as a community?
that's possible. That's possible. But I think for some microcontroller, for this one, we made it an open source. You can check all the details, all the information. But for some modules, we didn't make it open source. But yeah, definitely it's possible for you to design your own module. And since this is Arduino compatible, so whatever the Arduino modules or sensors or boards or shells, it's also compatible with this.
Our
ID is the same interface of but we are adding our information to it.
Which module holds the actual program?
This one, the core, we call it core module. You can consider this as the Arduino core.
So tell us a little bit about your business model. Are you making money off selling products? Are you making money from hackathons or sponsorships? Or are governments giving you money to put stuff in schools?
Sure. We have two major markets. One is the educational market. Basically, as I mentioned in my presentation, we develop a series of curriculum. And we already have our hardware, and we have the software to teach kids our computer coding. And then we have our curriculum. So we package them together as one package. Thanks for our modules concept, we actually became not like other company that they only have a robot, so they really have limited things to teach, but we can teach all scenarios in terms of STEM speed. So we have different level, we even have different level of curriculum, and then we sell it to schools. All the way from K to 12 to higher education. We even teach lots of class in college and universities for business in Tsinghua and Beijing University as well. So anyway, that's one major market. We sell it to schools. Another market is consumer market. We build our product like an innovative buggy. It's a consumer STEM toy. It's fun to play, but also it has lots of educational features. So we sell those to the consumer market using the Amazon or our own website, or even like Barnes & Noble, Fry's, those retailers.
What is the limit of the stackable modules? Do you not have adjustable pins that you can use, or is it multiplexers?
Yeah, I didn't even have an answer for you, but I think you can make it really tall of a stack of modules is still working. And also we have some extension board that you can put two modules like this. And we also have an extension module that you can put four modules together. So
I think when you like turn the LED on, actually reserving some pins
for, yes, for the IO, yeah, for the digital
support. Stack another one on.
Right.
Some pin is, you can designate some pin for some modules, right?
Right.
Just pass through.
Right. Yeah, but I guess used definitely has the limit, but I don't know what's the limit there. But I think we were also using the program, the software to somehow expand the limit. Okay.
What kind of licensing do you have to do with Legos to make modules compatible with Legos?
Yeah, that's a good question. Actually, most of us, we don't do the research about that. But actually, Legos patent already expired like 20 years ago.
Oh.
So as long as you are now using their trademark, you are totally fine. Interest is the best teacher. So in order to teach students or teach kids what happened to learn. You have to generate the engagement. I mean, the traditional lecture or traditional class versus the current class that we have is really the huge difference. Is a traditional lecture really just trying to give them all the knowledge, but they normally will refuse it. They will feel boring to learn math or physics or whatever. But when you try to have them to play Lego, let's say, or build the Eiffel Tower or a birthday cake, they really like to work on the product. And once they are working on the product, when they feel some problem or when they meet some problem or face some problem, they will try to find an answer. They will try to learn how to fix it. So that's the problem solving skill we're talking about. And that's the engagement we are trying to have. So basically, first we make all of our product like a toy like, very fun to play first. So hopefully when the kids play with it, then maybe you can gradually give them some idea of what is the logic. And then probably you can teach them, okay, how I can make this robot to go forward and then stop or delay for 3 seconds and then turn left. That kind of, we use the scratch block based drag and drop to do that. So kids will start learning some sort of logic or how I make it happen and so on and so forth. So we gradually give them the idea what is coding. And as they grow, then we can have them to learn C++, like Arduino IDE or Python and so forth. So that's our approach.
Yeah. Are systems that you construct entirely self-contained, or you have the ability to connect other kinds of sensors like yours or operate relays or those kinds of things? Is that possible?
Yes, yes.
The interface boards that say, hook your relays up to this and it'll work?
Yes. Because our for instance, this microprocessor is the same as the Arduino board.
Yeah.
So basically, we are compatible with all Arduino compatible module sensors and everything. Yeah. And in addition to this, we can switch the chip to something like even compatible with, 91 even, or some other standards. So, yeah.
It's not just toys. You can make, for example,
an
internet aware water softener toy.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly. We those kind of modules can be used in a lot of industrial applications as well. For instance, the Vulture Ag projects, actually that's a pretty advanced technology. Because imagine, I didn't go through the details. I want to save some time, but imagine actually the requirements of that ag, the power. Lifetime of power is 70 days.
Yeah.
So we talk about really, really advanced design to make the really limited power consumption.
What is the retail cost of the module?
I couldn't remember, but I think it's anywhere around $10, $8,000. Yes, we have I couldn't remember the name, but basically you put our Microduino modules on the board, and it looks exactly like the Arduino board. So with the same pinout, with the same everything.
Do you
find
any
cheap
set yet?
Sorry?
Have you flown any CubeSats yet?
No, not yet.
What are the languages that you will be recommending?
Currently, the most popular one, because we start from a major community, so the most popular one is Arduino IDE, of course. But we are supporting the Scratch. Right now, we even support the Scratch 3.0 language. Although they are not officially announced yet, but we already support Python already. And also Python, and we are working on several other languages as well, like the block. Okay.
So if you want to add multiple new modules,
sorry.
Well, if you want to, you start off with your basic robot.
Right.
You want to add additional modules. Can you add more LED lights or more?
Yes, definitely. Actually, we have lots of projects that we are adding so many LED lights to make a building. Like, we are building a city or building a, you know, some park for kids. So definitely, yes.
Now, does Scratch run on tablets, laptops, or smartphones?
Yes. I think we already have the cell phone version. And also we have the computer version with a PC and the Mac. And in January, we will have the tablet version for the iPad. Not yet. I think maybe our original Microduino module series, for some module can support this, but for the MQP series, since it's really designed for education for kids,
make sure to check up our meetup page, meetup.com/SGVTech. Is it up there? Yeah, there it is. Sign up to our Slack channel. Make sure you guys have signed up for Scale. Any other announcements? Okay, great. See you guys next month. Thanks for coming.
Thank you.